So how do we do this? Okay, we know about positives, we know about negatives. You guys are all smart, I'm not gonna dumb anything down, okay? So we're just gonna move on for that. All right. Okay, we're gonna get back in a little bit of physics now. Because it's what we have to do, okay? All right. The problem with, let's start with this one. I thought it was on the next frame. That's what happens when I don't look at the slide. Okay, when force is exerted during the concentric phase of the lift, fewer muscles are activated. Okay, why is this? All right, the body, again, is a very efficient machine. It likes to find that center. Okay, so what does it do? It realizes that, okay, let's take an example of a bicep curl. So I have a bicep curl, I'm gonna curl the bar. As I'm curling the bar, I actually have to pull the weight away from the earth, okay? So you have gravity pulling on it. So I'm actually pulling up the weight away from the ground. Now, as I'm lowering the weight, I don't have to do as much, okay? Because I'm not taking it away. All I'm trying to do is keeping my arms from getting ripped out of the socket, okay? So your body functions mainly to provide an injury prevention. So I'm lowering the weight down. I am not fighting gravity anymore. I'm going against it, okay? I'm like, I'm just putting it down. All right. Now here comes a problem. If more weight can be handled on the way down of a movement, but you can only pick so much up, it's logical to assume that the concentric part of the movement is going to limit the eccentric part of the movement. Okay, why? Because I can handle less weight doing this than more weight doing this. You guys follow? Okay, good. Because less fibers are used, more force is produced, we're fighting the weight versus going against gravity. Typical pyramid loading method is probably not going to work as well. Because the weakest, right? The strongest chain is by its weakest link, whatever that expression is the concentric form. I mean, the concentric part of the movement. I'm already going over all this. But that's it. So the concentric will limit it. So the problem is, I can lift this much, but I can lower more. But how am I going to lower more if I can't lift this much? Okay? So we're having an issue here. The next one is what I did with the incline bench press. That's why I put it on here. So I do 3 sets of 8 reps of concentric motion, about 80%, followed by 3 sets of 4 reps of assisted negatives only. So I do 3 sets of 8 reps, 80%. I put on about 120% at that point. The bar is lifted for me in each of the concentric part of the motion of the lift, and I lower it. So what are we doing? 3x8, chased by a 3x4, okay? So it's slightly different because we're not doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 5, that's the first one. The second one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you do that 3 times. And then you go by, somebody helps it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, help me up. 1, 2, 3, 4, you do that 3 times. Did you guys see the difference? We good? So, what are the positive side effects? We already listed the negative side effects. Those were listed under my warnings. The positive side effects. Okay. Increased muscle mass, which is what our physique athletes want. Improved energy expenditure, which is always great, which means, what does this mean? It means we can get more work done in less time with less energy, which I don't know anybody in any type of sport that doesn't want to do this. All right? Increased energy expenditure. Improved neurological function. You're making the body more adaptive, making it more efficient. So it's going to improve your neurological function. And of course, all this will also result, like I said, in decreased training time. You can get more in less time with less energy. Get in, get on, get out, go do what you